Hi, and welcome back to Rar Math. I am going to discuss with you some different ways to factor a polynomial. I'm going to start with greatest common factor. In this first video, I want to equate factoring a greatest common factor with prime factorization of a number. We talk about prime factorization in another one of my videos, which you can look up on the site. However, I'm going to show prime factorization done a little bit differently. When we're prime factoring a number, we're trying to find the prime numbers that multiply to the number. So if I have the number 30, I may notice right away that 30 is 3 times 10. Now, because 3 is a prime number, I don't need to worry about breaking that 30 up anymore. 10, however, is composite. It's made up of two other primes. If I take 10 and I break it up into 2 times 5, I've now completely broken down 30 into its prime parts. When you're factoring a polynomial and throughout factoring, and there are lots of ways of factoring, factoring's a huge concept in algebra, what you're really doing is you're trying to find prime polynomials that multiply up to the polynomial you're originally given. Now, I'm going to do it in this fashion where I divide out a number, bring it out front, and I have it multiplied to the rest of the polynomial. Because I want to think of a polynomial as being a single number, we use parentheses and we say, hey, this whole trinomial is really a single number. And just like we took a 3 out of 30, we say, hey, what can come out of x cubed minus 5x squared plus 3x? And we look at the three terms and it has to be something that comes out of everything. Eventually you'll learn other ways to factor a trinomial, but for now we are just focusing on greatest common factor. If I look at these, I notice that an x comes out of all of them. Now, there's lots of ways of writing this. You can just go ahead, put the x out front, parentheses, and write your trinomial reduced. Sometimes, especially with more complicated problems though, it's easier to think when you're factoring out the 3, you're dividing 30 by 3. So if I'm factoring out an x, I'm really factoring a single x, dividing a single x out of each term. Because I don't have an equal sign, the x doesn't just go away. Equal signs allow you to balance your equation and actually divide things out from both sides. We don't have from both sides. We're reorganizing. It's like cleaning up a room and moving your furniture and stuff around. We want to take that x and bring it out front. Well, when we divided one of the x's out of x cubed, we're left with two x's. When we factor one of the x's or divide one x out of 5x squared, we end up with minus 5x, and these guys cancel, leaving us with 3. And a really nice way to check your work is just multiply that x back through the trinomial, and when you distribute it into the parentheses, make sure you started off with your original problem. This is my first example on how to factor with greatest common factor. Please see the other videos if you want to see more complicated or more variety of problems. Thank you.